In this video, we are going to take a closer look at the way Eliud Kipchoge, one of the fastest marathoners in the world, runs. Many running injuries such as knee pain are correlated to repetitive, improper landing of the foot, otherwise known as initial contact. So today, we are going to focus on the way Eliud's foot lands on the ground as he runs. The first thing we will start with is the landing itself. In this race, you can see that he lands around the forefoot. Some research shows that forefoot landing is usually more efficient than heel striking when running at higher speeds, basically faster than a 6:25 min per mile pace. Forefoot landing also helps decrease knee pain during runs as it puts less stress on the joint itself. The next thing to look at is where the foot actually lands in relation to the body. Looking at where Kipchoge's foot lands, you can see that it basically lands right under the hip. Being in optimal alignment allows for muscles to work as efficiently as possible to propel forward as you run. This is important because if the foot lands too far forward or back, it takes more work to cover the same amount of distance, which could end up overworking the muscles, especially in long distance runs, and may result in knee or calf pain. The last thing I want to point out is the way he always keeps his knee slightly bent, not only at initial contact, but throughout the whole running cycle. By doing so, this allows for shock absorption and protects the joints, so you can run longer distances without getting that knee pain. And those are the three key things I saw pertaining to the way Eliud Kipchoge's foot lands during the Nike's Breaking 2. Hopefully you guys were able to take away some ideas to help optimize your running patterns so you can get that PR time you've always wanted or looking to finally run that marathon. Also, if you'd like to share your own experiences on running or have any questions about the video, please leave a comment below. And thank you for watching.